His word must be in us in order to have eternal life. If we have His word in us, we have Him in us. What is the message that comes from heaven through the Son of God? What is it that we should have in us that would be obvious by how we live our lives? We can tell if we have Him by how we live our lives. And what is the message that we should be living daily? Let me tell you, this then is the message that we preach to you, that God is light, and in God there is no darkness. If we say we have fellowship with God, if we claim that we know God, and we walk in darkness, we are liars, and we do not know the truth. But if we walk in the light, if we walk in purity and righteousness and holiness and godliness, if we obey His teachings, if we walk in the light, we have fellowship with God, and then the blood of Jesus cleanses us from all sins. If we walk in the light, we are cleansed by the blood of Jesus. If we say that we have no sin and we don't need the blood of Jesus, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. But if we come to Him and we confess our sins and call upon His name to cleanse us, to wash us clean, to change us, to give us His Spirit, to make us new people, to forgive us, then God is faithful to forgive us of all unrighteousness. If we say that we have never sinned, we make God a liar. We're calling God a liar, and the truth, His word, is not in us. These things, my children, these things have we written unto you. These things we're telling you right now so that you'll stop sinning, that you'll repent and live holy, seek godliness and righteousness. But if on that journey we stumble and fall, if any man sins during the process of seeking righteousness, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous. 1 John chapter 1, verse 8. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. What is this talking about? I thought Jesus said, be perfect, stop sinning, that we should strive to do this, and that it's possible to be without sin, to repent from our sins. Why does this say, if we say that we have no more sin, that we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us? This verse is commonly used to teach that you can't stop sinning, that you're always going to have personal daily sins in your life. But is that really what it's saying? Let us read the whole thing in context. Let's go all the way to 1 John chapter 1. That which was from the beginning, talking about what they've heard, what they've seen, what they've handled with their eyes, the word of life, which is Jesus Christ, saying that the life was manifested and they bear witness. And now they're bringing this witness to them, this eternal life, which was with the Father and was manifested unto us. We know that Jesus was manifested in the flesh. Now the things that we've heard and handled, we declare unto you that you might have fellowship with us, that ye also might have fellowship with us. This is talking about having fellowship with God and true believers. And our fellowship is with the Father and with His Son Jesus both. And these things we write unto you that your joy may be full. You're trying to tell us how to have fellowship with God. This then is the message. This is the message that they're bringing about fellowship with God. This whole passage is about having fellowship with God. This then is the message which we have heard of Him and declare unto you. What is the message that they're declaring? That God is light and in Him is no darkness at all. First of all, God is light. He has no darkness in Him at all. Now, If we say that we have fellowship with him and walk in darkness, we lie and do not the truth. How can we have fellowship with him if we walk in darkness? God is light. This passage is talking about having fellowship with God. How can we have fellowship with God? If we walk in darkness, we cannot have fellowship with God. So far, do you get it? Let's stay focused on the contextual message here. So if we walk in darkness, we cannot have fellowship with God. Let's go to the next verse. But if we walk in the light, as God is in the light, he's in the light, we walk in the light, then we have fellowship one with another. Then the blood of Jesus cleanses us from all sins. The blood of Jesus will cleanse us from all sins. How? If we walk in the light, as God is in the light. There is no sin in his presence. You cannot walk in the light and walk in the darkness at the same time. Maybe we should talk about that for one brief moment. What is the light? God is light. What is that light? It's truth, righteousness, holiness, godliness, purity. What is darkness? Sin, rebellion, stubbornness, pride, carnality, worldliness. We must understand that if we walk in the light, we are repenting from the darkness. If we walk in the light, there is no more darkness in us, no more sin, no more lust of the world. If we walk in the light, we have believed upon Jesus and we have repented from our sins, and that is how the blood of Jesus cleanses us from all sins. Did you know the blood of Jesus cannot cleanse you? If you do not walk in the light, it requires faith to walk in the light. We walk in the light by faith, by believing the teachings of Jesus, who said, repent and believe, who said, go and sin no more. If we believe in Jesus, we will walk in the light, and the darkness will fade from our hearts. At that point, the blood of Jesus will cleanse us from all sins if we walk in the light. Many people deny the cross and deny the blood of Jesus and deny that they even need a Savior. So verse 8 is not talking about daily sins that are still lingering in our lives that we can't get rid of. It's not talking about a person who is trapped by sin anymore. It is talking about a person who refuses to acknowledge the gospel message and says they don't need the blood of Jesus. They don't need him because there is no sin. They have no sin. And that is what verse 8 is talking about. Look closely. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. Verse 7 again. If we walk in the light, the blood of Jesus will cleanse us from our sins. But if the person says they have no sin, they don't need the blood of Jesus, they're deceived and the truth is not in them. The reason why we know this is not talking about daily sin left in our lives is because the whole passage, the whole context is talking about what? God is light, and if we walk in the light, we have fellowship with him. It's talking about not walking in darkness anymore. It's talking about how to have fellowship with God. We have fellowship with him if we walk in the light. We have fellowship with him. How can verse 8 say that we're going to continue in darkness? That would mean we have no fellowship with God. Verse 8 is not talking about continuous darkness in our lives. The whole passage is talking about walking in the light and no longer in darkness. And the blood of Jesus will cleanse us from sin. Verse 8, if we say that we have no sin in our lives and we do not need the blood of Jesus, we are deceiving ourselves. What instead we must do as humans upon the earth is verse 9, we must come to Christ and confess our sins. We need a Savior. We must go to him and repent and trust his teachings. Then he is faithful and just to forgive us all of our sins and to cleanse us from unrighteousness. We must admit that we have sin in our lives. Verse 8 is talking about confessing that you do have sin in your lives that needs to be forgiven from your entire life. Verse 10 confirms this once again. The context is not about daily sin. It's about overall lifelong sin as a problem that separates us from God. If we say that we have never sinned in our lives and do not need the blood of Jesus, we make God a liar who says we do need the blood of Jesus, and his word is not in a person who says such a thing. 1 John chapter 2, verse 1 confirms this whole entire context. My little children, why am I writing these things to you? That you stop sinning. Why do we stop sinning? Because we want fellowship with God. We have fellowship with God if we walk in the light. That you stop sinning, this means walk in the light. However, it does say that we may sin along the way. Verse 1 of chapter 2 does say that if any man does sin, it doesn't say you're always going to sin, my friends. It says along the journey of righteousness, as we're walking in the light, if we stumble, if we fall, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous. Isn't that beautiful? The passage is talking about fellowship with God, walking in the light, repenting from sin, living holy and pure. It's talking about how a person is cleansed by the blood of Jesus by going to Him and confessing their sins and being cleansed by the confession and repentance of sins. It's talking about a person who refuses to acknowledge their sin and who refuses to acknowledge the blood, need for the blood of Jesus and God as our Savior. They deny the cross and the gospel. These people, verse 8 and verse 10 are talking about, do not know the truth and are deceived. The passage is not talking about a person that will always continuously be a sinner. That would make you walking in darkness. The whole passage is talking about walking in the light. I hope you understand that now. Go tell everyone else this truth. Spread the word, my friends. Let's walk in the light so we have fellowship with one another. Hallelujah! He made a way by His grace. And by His grace we are saved if we believe and walk in the light. Through faith, we must obey and walk in the light. That is the path of righteousness. The grace and the blood will cleanse us if we believe unto righteousness. Hallelujah. Peace.